focus. Ideate. Innovate. Enable. CNBC TV18 and Clover Infotech present Digital Revolutionizing the Way We Bank.
Come to think of it, the way we do banking or access financial products is radically different from what it was some 10 years ago. Today, digitization has made it possible for people to transfer money, pay bills, book ticket, shop online, or invest in the stock market using their mobile phone or PC. The way disruption is taking place today, many experts say that ATMs, credit card, debit card, POS machine, mobile wallets will become passe. So what comes out loud and clear is that the banking and financial services sector is investing big time in digitization and in the process, revolutionizing the way we bank so as to keep the customers engaged and delighted. Digital revolutionizing the way we bank is our talking point. Joining me on the show is Biswaprata Chakravarti, CIO, IndusInd Bank, Mr. Deepak Sharma, CDO, Kotak Mahindra Bank, Mr. Javed Tapia, founder and MD, Clover Infotech, and Mr. Anup Purohit, CIO, S Bank. Gentlemen, welcome to the show. So if I may begin by asking you, digital technologies are being deployed across the BFI sector. So what have been the challenges for banks in this digital transformation, starting with you, Biswa?
I think from a banking perspective, when you look at the effect of digitization, it's no different from the industry at large. If you look at retail, if you look at any other industry like transport, everywhere there is a huge and pervasive impact. Banking is no different, insurance is no different. So what we are really seeing is convenience, security, anytime kind of a environment, and I would say extremely innovative products and solutions, which the customer no longer asks for. It's par for the course. I think the expectation is that banks and insurance companies innovate to bring those solutions to the market, which can create that kind of a compelling value proposition to the customer. So I would say, in short, that's the impact that digitization is having on the banking and insurance industry at large.
So to add to what Biswa was saying, unlike e-commerce companies, which are kind of a native digital, banks are not. So we have a legacy kind of systems in place, and that needs to be digitized. That's the first big challenge we have. There are four pillars which needs to be put in place to create the digital ecosystem for the better customer engagement, simply. The first one being the digital skeleton. And what I mean by digital skeleton is it needs to ensure that your core banking systems are API ready. So there are core banking systems and APIs are being formed. So there are systems which don't have APIs. So that's the first core area. You need to have your data lakes and the entire data warehousing solutions in place. You need to have microservices architecture. So that's the backbone, digital backbone or a skeleton needs to be put in place. That's the first part of it. The second one I would say is a digital reach. That's important because if you want to reach out to the vast customer segment, you can't use your brick and mortars every now and then, which means you need to have very clear channel strategy. When I say channel strategy, it's not only the mobility part of it, but mobility, right mobility solution for the right business segment, right for the SME, for the corporate, for the retail, and for the unbanked whoever keypad phones. So that strategy.
The backend should be ready for slicing and dicing the market.
Absolutely. Similarly, you need to have your APIs in place, integrating with the corporates, because that will give you stickiness. Now, again, the value what you see in the digital reach, particularly payment, is a classic example which we have on the table. Like when we integrate the entire payment ecosystem, we realize that this is adding lots of value to the bank and bringing. So for example, last month itself, we did 330 million UPI transaction. I'm talking about only UPI transaction worth 51,000 crore on this platform. We capture almost 40% of the AEPS market. The reason I'm putting it is that reach is important. Digital reach is important for you to reach out. Third pillar is the digital range. When I say range, so as you rightly said, historically banking has been brick and mortar, wherein all your bankings were done in a physical paper-driven process. We have to evolve to reach to a stage wherein customers are able to do a self-service digitally for themselves. It will take some time as a country. So obviously the second best option is a techno, what we call as a techno-personal, which is your assisted mode. So we have to reach to that level. All banking products have to be digitized, not only digitized as is, but digitized in what customer wants. So that is third pillar. Once you are able to digitize all your banking products, the fourth one is you will provide this experience to the customer. So this is the fourth pillar, which is key. And the other biggest challenge today, if you ask me. The customer experience today, you see on Amazon, probably it is 80 to 90% if I rate on a scale of 100. But in the banking, probably it is 20 to 30. Okay. It will still is a nascent stage. It will take some time.
Okay. Deepak, you heard two of your colleagues from the industry.
Yeah.
And they talked about four pillars. So your take.
So I would take a slightly different perspective because transformation, the way I look at it is, it starts with the business model transformation. Business model transformation starts with the change in customer habits. So what's the starting point of the transformation? Mm. I think today the starting point is the customer, because customers' choices are changing very, very rapidly. The loyalties are almost diminishing. Mm. And the business model, what was relevant yesterday, is no more relevant. And margins are under compression either because of competition or because of change in regulatory landscape or the new business model. And I think these are the realities in which the business has to be reimagined. Okay. If this is the reality, I think the three things that are paramount here, which needs to change fundamentally, is people. Mm-hmm. When I say people, it's about their skill sets, about their mindsets, about their reorientation to the new business model. Okay. The second is the process.
Yeah.
As to how do you redesign straight through process, real time, reduce number of checks, but still make sure that the fraud and risk is well embedded in the process. And the third I would talk about is the product.
Okay, yeah.
Because conventional financial products are no more relevant as the product becomes services. It needs to be embedded in different customer journeys. So I think these are the three fundamental changes. Technology is the great enabler to make all this happen.
Let me get Javed. Javed, most of the banks are your client. So you have an inside view and outside view. What's your take?
The customer being the center of the universe, I think that's very critical. Mm. Digital really gives you the power to make the customer the center of the universe, because customers demand more. They want to be want offers to be contextual. They want more customers, knowledge of their needs and their requirements, and they want banks to actually cater to those needs. They don't want to be addressed as one size fits all. They want curation, and that I think really is the key to how banks, you know, use digital technology to address their customers.
So if they were to win the digital race, their product has to be differentiated product experience.
So my take is that they're of course varying degrees of success.
Yeah.
Some banks have been that much more aggressive and have done a great job of it. Some are catching up. It's not that they're not cognizant of the fact that digital is the way to go, but I think everybody is in a different stage of the journey. To me, the key is the banks are structured around products.
Okay.
Now they have to be structured around the customer. And that's the one that I think Anup mentioned, Deepak mentioned about the mindset, which has to change in the organization of the bank to be put the customer first and put the organization that now is kind of fungible and is able to be to work in unison to address the customer needs.
CNBC TV18 and Clover Infotech present Digital Revolutionizing the Way We Bank. CNBC TV18 and Clover Infotech present Digital Revolutionizing the Way We Bank.
What the customer is essentially looking for is safety, security, and convenience. At the same time, he's also looking for personalized services. So how is this experience being delivered to the customers today?
So I think that's a very interesting one. I think customers are not looking at experience enablers on products and solutions and security differentially. I think security is part of the product offering. What I mean to say by that is customers want to transact, Anup talked about UPI, but if you look at broadly, the entire stack on payments, or if you look at how we have, provided service capabilities to customers on a self-service basis, we've always found that customers are willing to take those initiatives up. They're willing to embrace those. They're willing to look at ways and means to automate their service flows, right? Whether it's account opening, so for example, servicing, payments, funds transfer, all of those.
Yeah.
I think what we've noticed is, first of all, how context aware is your security infrastructure?
Okay.
Because the reality is the customer expects the bank to take those steps to protect his privacy, his data, his transaction, right? At the end of the day, the bank has to put in those kind of, ecosystem of solutions which cater to that.
Yeah.
So first is we have to be context specific, aware of what the customer is doing. And there are a lot of solutions which a lot of banks are implementing around, understanding the behavior of the customer, right? So on the internet side, what the customer is doing, what kind of transaction, what velocity, what kind of transactions he's performing, what's the frequency of those transactions, which space is he using that, which platform is he using, etc. Now, how do we embed learning, deep learning into it to understand that based on that behavior, you take actions which protect the customer from the perspective that, you know, either I step up or I make sure that there is a anti-fraud kind of a action that is taken. So you get into slowly into, you know, controls, fraud monitoring and those kind of areas.
I want to say one thing that in the digital world, the bank's IT is completely naked to the customer, because the customer is at all times accessing the information which is residing in the bank systems and has a complete visibility into that.
Absolutely.
So it's very critical for that to be secure and to be kind of up to the highest standards.
A study conducted by Bain & Company found that increasing the customer retention rate by 5% can lead to a 25 to 95% increase in organization profit. In the banking industry, the acquisition cost for customers is high. What are the key trends for a bank to further increase engagement with the existing customer? Are really people looking after the existing customer or always choosing the new one? What is your...
So I think we've kind of addressed that in terms of the whole part, you know, of the digital revolution being about customer centricity. Yeah. Now, how do you cater to the customer needs? Mm. And how do you make sure that the customer is... You're preempting the customer's requirements. You're not being reactive, but you're kind of anticipating them. Deepak mentioned about at the e-com sites, when you're buying something, there's a loan ready for you. Now, that's the kind of expectation from customers, that their needs will be addressed in real time, not at a later date. So I think that's one key aspect. I think the second aspect is about innovation. I think, you know, customers wants new products, new services to be delivered also. And I think that's where banks are innovating and coming up with solutions that customers are demanding. So we spoke about earlier about the insurance sector and how they are kind of, you know, dealing with that. But I think the banks also are coming up with specific solutions to meet the customer requirements. So I think these two would probably be the key elements to retain and engage with customers.
At one level, you go and acquire the customer.
True.
And thanks to demonetization and, you know, the jam trinity, almost 80% of transactions are digital. But I was told 60% of customers still rely on relationship managers with the bank.
True.
So can technology help here to keep the customer delighted constantly?
Absolutely.
Tech and touch model.
Absolutely. Today, digital ecosystem are at a various stages of evolution across the bank. Some banks are ready, maybe a digital offering on a particular channel, but not on the other one. So it's important that we do not give a disjointed experience to the customer on that. When it's analytics, once you have done the analytics, you have all the information available of the customer at the fingertip of your RMs. Now, coming to the question of techno-personal conversation, which you are saying. So what happens is some customers are still not comfortable in carrying out digital transactions. They still want to meet RMs. And you're right. Almost today, if we look at the retail banking business unit, almost that comprises of maybe 70% of the entire bank's manpower, because they are there.
Is it very Indian that people want the personal relationship?
Absolutely. We are in a transitioning economy at this point in time.
Okay.
The people who have money are the people who are our parents or probably of our age, and they still want to have a physical touch. Now, coming back to your question, at the same time, it is still important, because this transition will happen wherein customer would want to do self-help kind of a stuff. They don't want an RM. But at this point in time, if you have your digital ecosystem ready in the bank, through RM, if you are able to give instant gratification.
Javed, I want your comment. According to a recent study by Kantar, a market research agency, 91% of retail banks in India see the need to be customer-centric, but only 29% of customers believe banks truly offer customer-centric experiences. What do you think is the prime reason for this disconnect?
So I think Deepak mentioned about the three Ps, and I think the real key there is people and processes, which really need to now kind of gear up to this new way of dealing with customers, and how do you kind of really engage with customers more from a customer perspective rather than how they are structured internally. So I think organizational flexibility is the key to kind of making sure that this is, this is addressed. And the other part of it really being is that if you're putting the customer first, what you really need to also make sure is that the systems, the back-end systems that you have are all the channels that you have are working in unison. So I think Anup mentioned about how some experiences may be very good on the digital side, but the branch experience may not be so good. So you really need to bring all of that and make sure that customer is getting a unified experience from the bank.
CNBC TV18 and Clover Infotech present Digital, Revolutionizing the Way We Bank. CNBC TV18 and Clover Infotech present Digital, Revolutionizing the Way We Bank.
Deepak, you know, I think we can't take customer loyalty for granted. In this age of portability, people are switching, especially the millennials. So how do you use technology to keep the customer continuously engaged, delighted, so that it doesn't go away?
So the way we look at it, it's not just technology, to just give you a one sentence answer. I think the way I define and we define internally is there are five D's that defines the whole model.
Okay.
And the first is the most complex. That's the deep customer insight.
Okay.
Because that's more about behavioral science. It's more about how customers' emotions are connected. And I think so often we think technology can go and solve. Mm. Unless we know where the customer is, what he or she is thinking, what are their motivation or trigger or concerns. I think it's not that there is a homogeneous set of customers anymore. And I think bringing that in, which is what is I call the first D, which is the deep customer insight. The second is the design. Now, design itself is something which is relatively new in last few years. I think we have started to talk, invest a lot more about creating design thinking, building the design culture. And design is not just UI and UX as we commonly speak about. I think the third fundamental is about the whole model of development, where fail fast, because traditionally we used to build things with a very longer shelf life. I think today there are decisions and there are things that we develop on the fly. We test, validate. If it doesn't work, go back and change. That means you are in a constant state of development. There is no development cycle which has a start and an end date. Okay. And I think the fourth, what I call is the fourth D, is a deployment. Because your ability to run deployments concurrently all the time, and I think that's extremely critical. Because there are different customer sets. As we build certain applications, we just deploy and make it available to a certain set of customer and may not be to the whole lot. Learn from that experience and then decide how you want to scale up. And the fifth is what I call is how do you drive the ROI or the revenue out of those initiatives? Because finally, it has to have a payback for you to go back and build more. And I think unless we bring all these dimensions in a perfect harmony, just doing too much of one without supporting all other Ds is just going to fail.
What about user interface? How robust it is, the banking system?
Our way to attract and retain customer is user experience. And as a banking industry, that is where everybody is focusing to ensure that the customer journey is seamless, simple, easy to use, and focusing. Where have we reached a nirvana stage? I don't think so. Okay. It will take some time.
But I think as a bank, we are doing a lot of interesting stuff. For example, today, banking is available on not just internet and mobile banking, which was, I would call, the channels we had even 5 years back. Yeah. Today, you can connect on a WhatsApp.
Absolutely.
There are millions of customers today we have who connect on WhatsApp on banking, because a lot of them, they are not yet there on the mobile banking app, but they find WhatsApp a lot more convenient. Or like there are chatbots today which we have, be it on IVR, be it on your mobile phone or internet banking.
Physical aspect in the Indian context cannot be underemphasized. I think that is also very critical. And I think banks in India are they are cognizant of the fact that the physical is equally or more important, because we are used to that personalized level of service, which is very critical.
The Indian bank has come a long way. And the way disruption happened in the last 5 years is very good, actually, from the customer point of view. Mm. So when you do a crystal ball gazing, how will the future of banking be 5 years from now?
Okay. I think if you reimagine banking today and 5 years from now, I think a lot of partnership-based solutions are going to emerge. You cannot have one product and a set of products which is very unique to a particular company. Everybody will basically be in commodity. But it is how you embed that into a journey across an experience the customer has across two or maybe three companies, right? So that ultimately speaking, nobody owns the customer, but the customer is still yours to manage, to maintain, to serve, and to enhance experience. So I think how do we co-imagine and co-create a kind of environment where the customer is not restricted to any particular kind of an organization alone.
Banking is going to be a marketplace for the customers. It will be the lifestyle of a customer. And the way I look at it, it will get into a conversational mode of banking. That's what I see.
Markov, Deepak, you?
So one is what will remain the same is branches are still going to be there.
Okay.
And they'll stay relevant. Mm. What will define the change is I think banks will start looking more and more like technology organization. Strong on technology, data and analytics. That's going to be the new core of banking. The risk, trust, security will get redefined because that is even today core, but with the new emerging threat, I think a lot more around that will redefine banks. The third is the customer experience will take real center stage and it won't be just a good to say thing because that will define whether banks will have proximity or not.
Okay. Last word to you. You heard all the three bankers. So what's your take?
My crystal ball says, I agree with Anup, it's going to be a lifestyle bank based on technology, which is technology is going to be deeply embedded, drive the entire lifestyle of a consumer and address the consumer's needs at every step of the way. In most cases, preempting those needs, providing the customer with a very curated, very specific offering rather than one size fits all. To the point of branches that Deepak said, I would see a branch in the next couple of years of a bank having a nice Starbucks machine there with a coffee and with a little bit of a hotspot where you can come engage with your relationship manager. And I think the nature of banking is going to be about relationship, which is very specific to each individual customer. And I think that's going to make the difference when we talk about loyalty and we talk about customer engagement.
Okay, gentlemen, thanks a lot for being on the show. Pleasure talking to each one of you. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
CNBC TV18 and Clover Infotech present Digital, Revolutionizing the Way We Bank. Focus. Ideate. Innovate. Enable.